So your left hand for your introduction is going to go as follows. That just continues to loop. Now there's two instrumental parts for the right hand that you're going to need to know. The first one is going to go like this. And you'll see something similar to that surface later in the song. And then the second right hand part is going to go as follows. Putting everything together that I just showed you, this is your introduction. And keep in mind that at the end of the introduction, there's a ritardando. That means you gradually slow down and then you hit a fermata. That is, you hold out that last note as long as you feels right before going into the verse. And that is your introduction to this song. So this next part that I'm going to show you is the first part to your verses and the first part of the backing track to your chorus. It's going to go as follows in the right hand. This is the part that I was talking that was going to resurface. With that, the left hand is going to stay the same that it was before. Every fourth measure, you're going to get one of these thrown in right before the loop starts again. So the first part of your verses is going to go as follows. Right after that, like the lead into the chorus, there's a background choir part that comes in. It's real subtle. I like it a lot, actually. If you agree with me, thumbs up. That extra chorus part is going to go as follows, this choir part that underlies the verses. Putting that together with the left-hand part, this is the second part of your verses, which leads into the chorus. That's the first part of your verses and the second part of your verses. Now, there's one extra part you're going to need to learn for your backing track for your chorus. The first part is the same as the first part from the verses that I showed you before. The second part, there's a little high synth part that you're going to need to learn. That's going to go like this. Putting that together with the same left hand from before, I'm going to be playing it down here. It's the same what we were playing before. You should get something like this for the second part of your backing track to your chorus. second part of the backing track to your chorus. The Nate Dogg's classic vocal line is going to go like this in the chorus. Putting that together with the same left hand from before, you should get something like this for your chorus. Till I Collapse by Eminem featuring the late, great Nate Dogg. If you like these or any of the other videos you've seen on my YouTube channel, I'd like to encourage that you subscribe to it. And I'm always on the lookout for new songs to check out, new songs to potentially do lessons for, so if you have a song you want to learn or a song you're having trouble picking up, send it my way and I'll consider it for a future video. As always, I will see you next time.